Hello friends and welcome to Virtual TechBox YouTube channel. Today I will show you how to migrate the Windows 10 VMware virtual machine to Google Cloud and run the Windows 10 successfully on the Google Cloud. You can use this method to migrate any on-premise VMware virtual machine to Google Cloud. Let's start. To register to Google Cloud, open the browser and go to cloud.google.com. Go to sign in and enter your Gmail credentials here and click on start free trial. After that, it will ask you the few details of yours. You will also have to enter your credit card details, but they will not charge anything. It is only for verification purpose. And after the completion of registration, you will get the free trial period of the 90 days. Once your free trial period is over, it will not deduct anything automatically unless and until you go and make manually your account to be paid. Once you register to free trial period is completed, it will bring you to this page. On this page, you will have to press console and it will take you to this Google Cloud Platform console page. I will go to VMware Workstation. This is my Windows 10 virtual machine created on the VMware Workstation. I will provide the password for the admin to log in the virtual machine. I have logged in to Windows 10 virtual machine created on the VMware Workstation. If I go to run and I will type here the winver, okay, you can see here this is the Windows 10 version 2004. I will create new notepad on the desktop and I will name it as Google Cloud Test. I will open the notepad and I will type here Google Cloud Test document created on 30 September 21. I will save and close it. We will verify this notepad after the migration of the virtual machine. I will go ahead and shut down this virtual machine so that we can start the OVA export of this virtual machine. I will minimize the VMware workstation. And on the desktop, I will create one folder in which we will save the OVA export of the Windows 10 virtual machine. Windows 10 virtual machine has been shut down here. On the left side, I will select the virtual machine. I will go to File, Export to OVF, I will give the path to the folder which we have just created. Here I will change from .ovf to .ova. Okay. OVF export of the virtual machine has started, which will take some time to complete. OVF export of the virtual machine has been completed here. If I go to this folder, you can see complete virtual machine has been exported in the OVA format. I will exit the VMware workstation here. I will copy this URL and open it in browser. Here I will click on Cloud SDK installer, which will download the SDK exe. I will cut this exe and paste it on my desktop. I will double click to install it. Next, single user, next, install. SDK installation has started, which will take some time to complete. Here I will press next and finish. It will directly open the command prompt. I will type here Y and press enter, which will redirect me to this page. Here I will give my Gmail credentials. Allow. I will again go to command prompt. Here it is giving me two options to select the project. I will type the number one and press enter. My project has been selected. I want to select my zone, so I will type Y and press enter. My zone number is 37, so I will type here number 37 and press enter. My zone has been selected. Here SDK installation has completed and SDK has been given the all rights on my system. I will go to Google Cloud Console on my browser. And in the console, I will go to menu. Cloud storage, browse. Create bucket. I will give here my bucket name, mylab hyphen bucket 04. continue, region. In the drop down, I will select my region. Continue, standard, continue, continue, create. My Google Cloud bucket has been created successfully here. Now we have to upload the OVF file of the virtual machine from my local system to the Google Cloud bucket. For this, we will use one command on the command prompt. In this command, this is the path of my OVF file on my local system. And this is my Google Cloud bucket. I will copy the complete command and I will paste it on command prompt and I will hit enter, which will start the uploading Windows 10 virtual machine OVF file to my Google Cloud bucket. This upload will take time to complete. Here, OVF file upload has been completed to my Google Cloud bucket. Now we have to create the Windows 10 virtual machine from the OVF file, for which we will use one command. In this command, this is the OS version and this is the path of the OVF file inside my Google Cloud bucket. I will copy the complete command and I will paste it in CMD. I will hit enter, which will start creating the Windows 10 virtual machine from the OVA file. Here it is showing that logs are available at this URL. I will select this URL and I will copy it. I will paste that copied URL to browser and I will hit enter. On this page, we can actually monitor the progress. You can see here it is running. This virtual machine creation will again take some time. Here you can see Windows 10 virtual machine creation has been completed successfully and these are the logs. If I go to CMD, here also it has completed, which means we have created the Windows 10 virtual machine successfully. We'll be right back. I will go to dashboard. Okay. I will go to menu, compute engine, VM instances. And you can see here, this is the our Windows 10 virtual machine which we have just created, and it is running. I will copy the public IP of the Windows 10 virtual machine. And I will go to my local system. I will go to run mstsc. Okay. I will paste here the copied public IP. Connect. I will give here the username admin. I will provide the password for the admin. Okay. Yes. Here we have successfully logged into the migrated Windows 10 virtual machine over RDP. If I open this notepad, you can see it is the same notepad which we had created on the source virtual machine, which means we have successfully migrated our VMware Windows 10 virtual machine to the Google Cloud. You can use this method to migrate any on-premise VMware virtual machine to Google Cloud. I will provide all the commands used in this video in the description. That's it today, friends. Like the video, share it with the friends and spread the knowledge. Subscribe to channel. I will see you in the next video. Thank you.